بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, our last lesson we were talking about the first principle, or the first naqid min nawaqid al-Islam, the first nullifier of the Islamic faith, and we said that it was shirk. And shirk is one of the greatest sins that a person can do. And in the last part of the principle, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Al-awwal al-shirk fi ibadatillah. He, as mentioning the first naqid min nawaqid al-Islam, and the greatest one, which is shirk, committing polytheism. And he said, Al-shirk fi ibadatillah ta'ala, associating a partners in the worship of Allah the Almighty. He said, قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرِكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءَ. That Allah the Almighty says, verily Allah does not forgive that a person associates partners with Him, but He forgives other than that for whomsoever He pleases. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكَ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةَ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارُ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and verily, whoever associates a partner with Allah, then Allah, you know, has committed shirk, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited them from paradise, and their abode is the hellfire. And for the zalimeen, those wicked sinners, there is no ansar. There is no one who will help them and support them and save them from the hellfire on the Day of Judgment. Then the Shaykh said, وَمِنْهُ أَذَّبْحُ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ كَمَنْ يَذْبَحُ لِجِنِّ أَوْ لِلْقَبْرِ. So the Shaykh mentioned in the last part of the first naqid, he said, and from it, meaning from shirk, is أَذَّبْحُ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ كَمَنْ يَذْبَحُ لِجِنِّ Olil Qabri. And from the types of shirk, so here the Shaykh mentioned first in general shirk, then in the end of the same principle or the same nullifier of the Islamic faith, he mentioned from it is sacrificing to other than Allah, similar to the way some of the people sacrifice to the jinn or to the graves, letting us know that in the time of Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, some of the people sought to come closer to Allah by sacrificing to the dead, sacrificing to the graves, offering their offerings, sacrificing animals, slaughtering the animals, maybe in the name of graves, the people, the inhabitants of the graves, or in the name of jinn. People used to sacrifice to the jinn. And people still practice this un-Islamic, paganistic practice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قَالَ تَعَالَى قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايِ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, say, and this is an order to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايِ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say that my salat, my prayer, وَنُسُكِي, and my sacrifice, وَمَحْيَايِ وَمَمَاتِي, and my life and my death, is for Allah, the Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of the worlds. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ, and He has no partners. وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ مُسْلِمِينَ, and with that I have been ordered, and I am the first of the Muslims. That ayat is very, very profound, and Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan mentioned some very important benefits. He says, first and foremost, that the general meaning of this verse is that Allah commanded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say to the pagans who used to worship other than Allah and sacrifice to other than Allah. So this was a paganistic practice. And this is a practice that many people who say La ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, they still practice the same practice. They sacrifice to the jinn. Meaning when they go to get a sheep or a goat or a camel or a cow or whatever, they slaughter it and they say in the name of this jinn, in the name of Sayyid Bedouin, in the name of so-and-so. So they slaughter the sheep, slaughter the cow or the camel in the name of someone else besides Allah. Sometimes they slaughter it in the name of Allah. They say Bismillah, but their intention is to bring it, is to come closer to that person who died and who is an inhabitant of the grave, or that Sufi saint, or the jinn. They seek protection from the jinn, so they think that by slaughtering an animal, they've offered a sacrifice to the jinn. Is this permissible in Islam? No. Absolutely not. This is Muharram. This is shirk. This takes you, this is a major form of shirk, which takes a person out of the fold of Islam. And that's why Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab mentioned that as one of the types of shirk. He mentioned a specific type of a specific practice in the general principle of shirk. And so in this verse, as Sheikh Salih ibn Fawzan explains, that the general meaning is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say to the mushrikeen that any type of worship to other than Allah is shirk. So regardless of whether it was sacrificing to other than Allah, this is shirk. And that I am directing, meaning the Prophet ﷺ is directing, making all of his ibadah, his prayer, his sacrifice to Allah, and his life and his death to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is from iman, all of his amal, all of his righteous deeds are for Allah. And that is the example for the believer. So that is what the general meaning of that ayah, and that all of those actions, all of those acts of worship are directed to Allah alone, who has no partners. And the opposite, and that that I am one of the believers. And the people who do opposite to that, they are the people of the mushrikun, those people who commit shirk. Letting us know, as Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan mentions, that this verse shows us, is evidence, that sacrificing to other than Allah is shirk. And the benefits that we gain from this ayat, as the Sheikh mentions, is that sacrificing to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shirk al-akbar. It's the shirk that takes you out of the fold of Islam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in that verse that it is comparable to salat. So that means when you sacrifice to other than Allah, it is a type of worship. That means you are worshiping other than Allah. You're directing a type of worship to other than Allah. The same way that if you pray to other than Allah, this is shirk. So can you pray to the jinn?
No.
Can you pray to Jesus?
No.
Can you pray to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
No.
Can you pray to Prophet Moses alayhi salatu wasalam?
No.
Can you pray to the angels?
No.
What about the trees?
No.
Or the rocks?
No.
Or elephants?
No.
Okay, all of those acts are ibadah. They're all types of worship, and they are all constitute shirk. They will take a person out of the fold of Islam. So even if you see someone, they're saying ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and they're in the masjid, they're praying in the masjid, but they sacrifice to other than Allah, they are committing the major shirk, which negates their Islam. It makes their Islam no longer. It makes them not a Muslim. وَعِيَّذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. So it's a major sin, something we have to stay away from. And this ayat also shows us that we have to have ikhlas lillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْهَرْ. And pray, then pray to your Lord and sacrifice. Letting us know that what? Salat and prayer are ibadah. They're types of worship. So then when a person directs their sacrifice to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is shirk. And a serious and very dangerous thing. An Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qal, haddathani Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi arba kalimat. لعن الله من ذبح لغير الله لعن الله من لعن والدي ولعن الله من أوى محدثا ولعن الله من منها غير منار الأرض رواه مسلم. In this hadith that was narrated by Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me four kalimat, four phrases or four statements. He said, "La'an Allah man dhabaha li ghayri la." The first one was, which is the shahid for us, is Allah curses the one who sacrifices to other than Allah. "Wala'an Allah man la'ana waliday," and Allah curses the one who curses his parents. "Wala'an Allah man awa muhtathan," and Allah curses the one who commits a bid'ah, or does something which is not from the religion of Islam and considers it something from Islam, that they commit a new act of worship in Islam. وَلَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنَهَا غَيْرَ مَنَارَ الْأَرْضِ, and Allah curses the person who changes the signpost on the earth, meaning does it in order to attempts to make it so it's difficult for the people to know the path, the correct way. So if a person changes the signs on the path in order to distract the people and make the people go astray, then this person is cursed as well. So it shows us these are all major sins. And the first one that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, was "La'an Allah man dhabaha li ghayri Allah," that Allah curses the one who sacrifices to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that shows us that that is a major sin, and it is a type of shirk. And in relation to this, Ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned many benefits. He mentioned that the people, that it is an un-Islamic practice to sacrifice to come closer to kings and leaders. For example, the people, when the leader has come out of the hospital and people have they sacrifice animals on behalf of the leader, making ta'zim, exalting the leader, that these are pre-Islamic practices that are not permissible, and they are means to shirk. Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, one of the great scholars of this time, he mentions that this is an un-Islamic practice, similar to the way that it is not permissible to qarrab bidhabhi lijinn, O al-Malaika, O al-Kawakib, O al-Asnam, O ashab al-Kabur, wa ghayrihim min al-Mukhluqeen, li adilat al-Mathkura. He said that it is also likewise not permissible to sacrifice for jinn in order to come closer to the jinn, or to the malaika, or to the angels, sacrificing animals to the malaika, or to the stars, or to sunam, to statues and so forth, or to the people in the inhabitants of the graves, or anything or anyone other than them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. And he also mentions in another one of his fatawa that it's no problem if you sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you want to just sacrifice an animal in order to be kind to your guests, to give them the best food that you have, or for your family. He said there's no problem with this because this is mentioned in the Sharia. It is mentioned that it is mashru' idha da'at al-haja ilay wa laysa min adh-dhabhi lighayri Allah. He said that this is not from sacrificing to other than Allah. If there is a need, you know, like of course in the aqiqah, the wedding, the party for the sacrifice for the people having the children, or the marriage, the walima, and so forth, or for your guests, that this is not sacrificing for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but these things are mentioned in the Sharia. There is nusus that show that this is from the kitab and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that this is a permissible type of sacrifice, and your sacrifice is that you are doing it in order to show thankfulness to Allah, and not to make ta'zim of the creation, or exalting the creation. So in this situation is permissible. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. And in the next lesson we will actually start the second nullifier of Islam, which is about seeking intercession. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.